You're walking along the beach and suddenly the ground shakes. Moments later, the water recedes quickly. Do you know what to do? Also, what if you were down on the waterfront and sirens went off? Do you know what that means? The open ocean coast of Washington is primarily threatened by two types of tsunamis. The first, called the near-field tsunami, is generated by earthquakes throughout the Cascadia subduction zone. When that earthquake happens, depending on where you're on the coast, whether on the southwest coast or say inland near Port Townsend, it can be anywhere from 30 minutes up to over an hour before tsunami waves arrive. In that case, the person on the beach would have to react on their own to recognize natural cues such as ground shaking or the recession of the water quickly going away. The second tsunami threatening the open ocean coast of Washington is a far-field event caused by earthquakes somewhere else on the Pacific Ocean margin, such as Alaska or over in Russia. There'd be hours before the event were to show, so that's something where the sirens would go off and you'd have support from local emergency management to evacuate the area. The overall risks, though, to each community is really in the hands of the communities themselves.
There will be different types of warnings for both types of events. For a local Cascadia subduction zone event, there'll be natural warning signs. The ground will shake, for example. Water may recede from the shoreline. In those instances, you need to be prepared to move to inland or to high ground immediately. From a distant event, such as one that would occur in Alaska or Japan, for example, there'll be more time to issue official warnings that would be broadcast through local media, through NOAA weather radio, as well as through the all-hazard alert broadcast or AHAB sirens that are located along the shoreline.
We have basically a multi-layered warning system because we recognize that people are not able to hear a warning by just one single source. One single source creates gaps in the warning network, and what we've stressed is that people need a NOAA weather warning radio in their home so they can hear that actually inside their house. Then we also partner with the local fire departments. We ask them in certain instances to just drive the beach and issue warnings to people actually on the beach. If you were on the coast and you were to receive a tsunami warning, you would need to move immediately to high ground. That tsunami warning can last for up to a 24-hour period. In some cases, now a local event where the ground actually shakes, you may not be able to actually leave the area and get to 50 feet above sea level, which is what we use as a rule of thumb for high ground. You may only be able to get as high as the second story of your home, or if you don't have a second story home, the second story of a neighbor's home. It's obviously safer than staying at sea level. Many times tsunami waves come in series of 6, 7, 8 waves. We don't know at this point in time how to predict which wave will have the most impact, which wave will be the most dangerous. So we ask that people stay at high ground for a minimum of 24 hours. You need to be personally prepared for that event. An evacuation kit should contain those items that you feel are necessary to sustain you for 24 hours. It's very, very basic. A small first aid kit, first off. Any medications you or your family might need throughout the course of a 24-hour period. Granola bars, bottles of water. Every family needs to think this over carefully and make plans that are suitable specifically for their family.
You have to prepare to be able to move quickly, because if the ground shakes, you should first drop, cover, and hold. And then as soon as the ground quits shaking, you need to evacuate inland or to higher ground. Look around and be familiar with your environment. Be aware of where you are, and one of the things that can help you with that is the signage in your communities. Look for the areas that will be in low-lying areas that may be affected by tsunamis. Look for the areas that tell you where to go to safety. Follow the road signs that show you how evacuation routes are. Look for the walking routes. They may be different. In our community, we have the yellow brick road, only because it helps people remember that's the evacuation route. Look for assembly areas. Go to the assembly areas. Look at the signage there. The signage may be such that it provides valuable information, like location for GPS, elevation, height, and numbers, so everybody knows where you're at. Also in our communities, we have evacuation maps. They tell you where your driving evacuation routes are, where your walking routes are.
Anytime you're involved in an emergency event, such as a tsunami, the very best thing you can do is plan in advance. It helps you remain calm. It helps you go through your plan. I encourage people to practice their plan, practice their evacuation route. When the day comes, you know what you're doing. You feel that you're in control. If you feel that you're in control, you remain calm.
We can't control the tsunami hazards on the open ocean coast of Washington, but we can hopefully manage the vulnerability of individuals and communities to these tsunami hazards. We can understand if we're in a tsunami zone, whether we're at work, at home, or out playing on the coast. We can have a NOAA weather radio to inform us if a far-field tsunami is on its way. We can understand natural cues like ground shaking and shoreline recession if a near-field event were to occur. We could practice our evacuation routes, know where they are and practice them with family members and neighborhood members. We can look around to see if other folks around us might need some help in evacuating, such as people in a daycare, an adult residential care, and work with local business owners to help understand, to help them understand the tourists that might need assistance also. Although we can't control future tsunamis from hitting the open ocean coast of Washington, we can reduce our vulnerability to these tsunamis by taking time now to educate and prepare ourselves.